Ever find yourself wondering about the Star Trek multiverse, its concepts and characters? Do you spend your time thinking about how deep Star Trek goes? Hi, this is Trekspertise, where we discuss all things science fiction through the lens of Star Trek. Today's episode, we discuss how the fictional Earth society depicted in Star Trek is the inheritor of a successful feminist movement. In order to explore this topic, we must first define feminism, which, in its simplest form, is this: a women's advocacy movement that seeks political, social, cultural, and economic equality with men. Despite all you might have heard about what feminism is over the years, it really just comes down to equality.
Feminism, by definition, is the belief that men and women should have equal rights and opportunities.
Now, the thing to note is that the human society depicted in the prime Star Trek universe is a post-feminist society. And by post-feminist, I mean that in Star Trek, the feminist movement has been successful. The future, represented by Gene Roddenberry and the franchise's other writers, has dealt with inequality between men and women so firmly that no one even questions whether men and women are truly equal. Characters certainly do not, on average, tell women that they cannot do things like lift heavy objects or captain starships solely because they are made of girl. So, how does a successful feminist movement manifest itself in such a fictional future? For starters, equal working relationships between men and women occur frequently. Women are depicted working alongside men without incident, friction, or even comment. If you've watched enough Star Trek, you tend to see past this dimension after a while. However, switch gears to modern television or film, and especially modern depictions of historical settings, and you are quickly reminded of the status quo that feminists are working to change.
Chloe, the estrogen's getting absorbed by your skin. That's why you've been all bloated and moody and a giant pain in the ass.
Even in modern television settings here in the 21st century, women are sometimes allowed to do the jobs of men, but the positions tend to be questioned, or ladies in those positions harassed either by characters or the writers themselves. Even more questionable, women are still, in this modern age, depicted as accessories to men, constantly.
I've heard it said that satisfaction is the death of desire.
Interesting. Do you need a tampon? I think I have an extra in my purse.
Ow, whoa, look at the time already.
Star Trek made sure to depict as much equality as possible right out of the gate. In the very first pilot, Gene Roddenberry and company wrote in a character called Number One, the second officer aboard the original Starship Enterprise. It was a bold move to have a woman in such a position, and it was largely unheard of in 1960s television.
Engineering deck will rig to transmit ship's power.
Nothing will be said if any volunteer wants to back out.
In fact, it was so unheard of that NBC executives asked that Number One be removed when they asked for the pilot to be reshot. Nevertheless, Roddenberry and most of the forward-thinking writers of Trek worked to push the equality of women in the show, from the original series onward. This unquestioned equality is so strong among humans of Starfleet that it only comes up through encounters with outsiders, such as in episodes like The Next Generation's Angel One.
Is this man implying that we put a lesser value on life than you do?
And Code of Honor.
I see. You too understand the proper value of women.
Even so, many species in the Star Trek multiverse exist at various levels of sex and gender equality.
Yes, Captain, you've been operating under a misconception. It is the men who are the slaves, not the women.
Even the Klingons, a species one might argue as being very masculine in terms of culture, consider women to be warriors equal to men. In addition to equal working relationships in Starfleet, women were occupying key positions of leadership also without issue, the most prominent of which is Captain Catherine Janeway of the USS Voyager. Among the Trek fandom, the popularity of Star Trek Voyager is regarded as a bit of a mixed bag. In fairness, Voyager does have a few weaknesses, and what Star Trek show doesn't?
Come on, Bones, what's the mystery?
His brain is gone.
However, the captain is not one of them. Voyager is, as Ian Gray of RogerEbert.com says, the most feminist show in American television history, and Captain Janeway is one of the big reasons why. No one ever challenged Janeway because she was a woman. The crew never complained that she was too emotional, weak-willed, or not logical enough for command. The crew didn't even say anything about Janeway's lack of romantic relationships. And you know why? because Starfleet captains don't typically have time for that kind of stuff. Unlike one captain we all know, the position doesn't generally allow for enough time to sleep with a quarter of the galaxy. And no one ever accused Janeway of not being tough enough for command either. In fact, no one on the crew said anything of the sort, ever, because it was well beyond normal that a woman can occupy the captain's chair in Starfleet. As you can see, many such captains existed throughout Star Trek history, playing small, medium, and large roles in various Trek episodes and series. This isn't to say that Trek writers don't use Trek as a vessel to talk about feminism and women's issues. They certainly do. And this isn't to say that Star Trek is perfect in its depiction of a post-feminist future. Certainly not. There have been plenty of inadvertent offenses throughout the years, and several flat-out failings.
But I will need some help. Turn around. Now.
There is plenty of work to do to clean up the sexism that has found its way into the franchise. Plenty of very possible work. Nevertheless, Star Trek is aiming for a higher feminist mark most of the time, and that is what most of us love about the show. It is the sort of future that we need our daughters, sisters, wives, and mothers to believe in. Desperately. In the Star Trek universe, women are allowed to choose their own sexual destiny, work alongside people of other sexes and races, and hold positions of power without intimidation, humiliation, shame, guilt, harassment, and subjugation. None of the wink-wink, she can drive the ship, but can she park it nonsense. They are respected and sought out as intelligent beings, first and foremost within the core human culture of the United Federation of Planets. Thank you for watching. Please feel free to leave comments below and subscribe to the channel for future episodes.